Megalights are a new type of light in Unreal Engine 5.5 that improve shadows and performance, especially in big scenes. They reduce flickering and work great with Lumen. But how do they work, and should you use them? Let's find out. The key advantage of Megalights is how they handle shadows. Traditional lights can produce harsh edges or flickering shadows in large scenes. Megalights smooth out those artifacts while maintaining real-time performance. They also interact well with Lumen, making them ideal for realistic lighting setups. To better explanation of Megalights, I've set up a scene with two emissive lights. Let's take a look. I also have a simple sequence set up with a cine camera. The camera is using its default settings. For example, if I disable the camera view, the lighting and shadows remain the same. Now let's make sure Megalights are turned on in the project settings. Search for Megalights in the settings search box. In my case, they're already enabled, but if they're off in your project, turn them on. If Unreal Engine asks you to restart, go ahead and do that. Now I'll select the post-process volume from the outliner and then search for Megalights in the details panel. Once it's enabled, you'll notice that the shadows on the wall and ceiling no longer flicker. Let me show you up close. I'll disable the camera view and move closer to the wall. There's a perfectly sharp shadow here. Now, let me show you the difference when I disable Megalights. I'll select the post-process volume again from Outliner. Now that Megalights are disabled, you can see the shadows have rough, flickering edges. Let's turn Megalights back on, and you'll see the shadows look much smoother and more stable than before. Now let's check the ceiling light. I'll move over to that spot and disable Megalights. Wait, let me first adjust my viewport so the ceiling is clearly visible. There's something off with the shadows on the ceiling. You may have already noticed. Now let's enable Megalights, and you'll see the shadows are correct and updating in real time, staying smooth and stable without any impact on performance. Now, as I move to the outdoor scene, and here let's get close to this window, you'll notice the rain and the nice shadows and reflections on the window surface. But if I disable Megalights, you'll see the reflections start flickering and become noisy. These are the emissive lights. But if you're wondering, what about regular lights, like a point light? When the post-process volume is set to unbound, Megalights affect the entire scene. But to clear any doubts, I'll select a point light that was used for the neon sign. To find the light quickly, I'll select the point light that's renamed as neon light, then press F on my keyboard to focus the viewport on it. If we search for Megalights in the details panel, you'll see that Megalights are enabled by default. The Megalights shadow method is also set to default, but if you want more accurate shadows, you can switch it to ray tracing. But keep in mind, enabling ray tracing for Megalights can impact performance in your games. Let me show you an important part of a clip from Unreal Engine Fest that highlights Megalights in action. I'm not sure, but some Unreal Engine users might have thought these were Megalights. In reality, they're just screen lights created using emissive materials. Now I'll show you how to create those lights in Unreal Engine, achieving a realistic lighting effect. Now I have a basic level set up. Let's add a cube to the scene and reshape it to look like a screen. Now I'll go to the content browser and create a new folder for the clips we'll use for our screen light. Here I have an Elden Ring clip to demonstrate this screen light. If I just drag and drop it into Unreal Engine, it will be imported as a media file. Now right-click on an empty space in the content browser, go to Media, and create a media player. Also make sure to check Video Output Media Texture, then press OK. Double-click on the media player to open it, then double-click on the video file. In the playback section, enable Loop, so the video plays continuously without stopping. Now we can save and close this window. Now we can apply this video texture to the mesh. We have a daytime scene here, so I'll rotate the directional light to create a nighttime setting and check if the screen is emitting any light. So, to make our mesh emit light, we need to double-click and open the material. Inside, you'll see our texture. Just connect the RGBA channel to the emissive color input, then click Apply and Save before closing the window. Now we have a screen light, but if I press Play, the video won't start playing. So next, we need to control its playback inside our level blueprint. You can ignore this error. Now I'll click on the blueprint button and open the level blueprint. Most of the time, the level blueprint isn't empty, but I cleared mine to show you the process from scratch. Now right-click and search for Event Begin Play. Now let's create a variable. Click the plus button, name it Media, and by default, its type is set to Boolean. Click on Boolean to change it. Then in the search bar, type Media Player. From the list, select Media Player. From those, choose Object Reference. Now drag and drop this variable into the graph editor. Since we need to access the media's information, select Get Media. From the Media node, drag out a connection, search for open source, and add it to the event graph. Now let's connect Event Begin Play to open source, and in the Media Source dropdown, select the clip we used for our screen light. Now click the Compile button. You'll notice a new option appears in the Details panel. Here, select our media player, then click Compile again, save and close the level blueprint window. And now when we click the Play button, our video starts playing. All good, but what if we need to control the intensity and create a more realistic light with proper shadows? Let's add a rect light to our scene, and I'll place it in front of our mesh. So first, let's change its mobility to movable. And now, scroll down to find the Source Texture option in the Rect Light settings. Then, drag and drop your video file texture into the Source Texture slot. Now, if we want to increase or decrease the brightness of our light, we can adjust the Rect Light's intensity. But for now, I'll keep it as it is. And the most important step now, we need to resize the Rect Light source to match the size of our screen or mesh. This ensures it accurately mimics the light and shadows from our video or any animation we're using in our game. Now I'll switch back to lit mode and click the play button. Now the light and shadows are completely accurate. This method works well if you want to use your clips to light up your scene in games. However, some Unreal Engine creators might prefer to use this technique in cinematics. So now I'll show you a simple way to use video playback inside Sequencer. Let's create a level sequence and name it Test. Now I'll click the Add button and add a media track to our sequence. Now click the plus button, go to Media Source, and select a clip. I'll choose the Elden Ring clip that I'm using to showcase these lights. Now right-click on the clip in Sequencer, go to Properties, and select the media texture we created for our video. And now, when we press the spacebar, the video will start playing. Since the video is quite long, I'll adjust the working range to 2500. Now we can play the video again and even add a camera to our sequencer to create a product showcase, like a brand new OLED monitor that we probably won't buy, but at least we can make it look great in Unreal Engine. Let me adjust the focus to make sure the screen is sharp and clearly visible. Keep in mind that when your sequencer is set up and you press play, the video playback won't work in game mode. But don't worry, this is normal. Just make sure not to open Sequencer while testing it in your game. And now let's talk about the Megalights settings for this. By default, when you add a light to your scene, Megalights are already enabled. The Megalights shadow method is set to default, as I showed earlier in the video. But if you want more accurate shadows, you can switch it to ray tracing. You'll notice an improvement in shadow quality. Since there's only one light in my scene, the performance impact is minimal. However, in a larger scene, I recommend keeping the shadow method set to default to maintain performance. Now let's max out the light attenuation radius and increase the intensity. The exact values depend on your environment, but I just want to demonstrate the effect here. And now let's play the video and you'll see the light interacting perfectly with surface because of Lumen in real time. If we need to add another screen light, the process is exactly the same. So I'll just duplicate the cube mesh and the rect light. Now I'll go to the clips folder, create a new folder, and move the existing clips into it. You can name it whatever you like. Then I'll create another folder and import a new clip to demonstrate the next light. Let's create a new media player, select our clip, enable looping for video playback, then save and close the media player. Now let's apply the video media texture to our new screen. Next, we'll open the material and connect the RGBA output from the texture sample node to the emissive color input. After saving and closing the material, we'll move to the rect light, and assign the new video texture in the source texture slot. Now that the lighting and shadows are correct, let's add this new screen to our level blueprint. Open the level blueprint. Here, I'll duplicate the existing variable. Now click the compile button. Next, I'll duplicate the media and open source nodes for the new media player. And on the new open source node, select the new clip we imported. And now connect the previous open source node to the new one to link it with event begin play. Then I'll compile and save. One more important thing, make sure the correct media player is selected inside the media node. To double check, I've organized everything into separate folders. Now, when you hover over the media player, you can verify that it's the correct one by checking the file path. And once everything is set up, simply compile and save the level blueprint and you're good to go. Now I'll set up this clip in my sequencer and play the videos. And that's everything you need to know about Megalights. Whether you're using them for in-game lighting or cinematics, they offer a powerful way to enhance your scenes. If you found this helpful and want to support my work, consider joining my channel membership or supporting me on Ko-fi. It really helps me keep making these deep dives into Unreal Engine. Thanks for watching.